palm, hand palm, foot palm, cubit, and stride. What we can say? Stride. These devices means these measurable things we were utilized to measure the length in our ancient time. What are those? Palm, hand palm, foot palm, cubit, stride. Palm, what we know as palm, this is the palm. This surface we were used to count the length. And hand palm, this is the hand palm. In general language, hand palm, what we can say? Jana. What we can say hand palm in general language? Jana. This is what we can say, front surface of the hand. Front surface of the hand means what we can say? Palm. That is a palm. Okay? And coming to that, what I'm saying to you? Foot palm. Foot palm means what we can say? One feet. One feet. By using our leg, we have to measure. And cubit. Cubit in our general language, what we can say? Mura. This is from elbow to tip of the largest finger. And stride. Stride, it is the distance between walkable length between the water legs. Walkable length between the legs. Those strides. These were, we were utilized in our ancient time. We were utilized for small length, for small distances, what we can say. These are some conventional methods. What are those? Conventional methods. These all what we can say, conventional methods. Conventional methods were utilized to measure the least distances. Least distances means low length or short length. To measure we were utilized such as those. Okay? Above conventional unit measurable is not accurate. These are not accurate. What we can say? Not accurate means not exactly. What we are measuring that length, what is the methods we were utilized to measure the length? By using these methods to measure the length, those are not giving always accurate, not giving exactly length, not giving exactly manner. Why? Because if suppose already we discussed, if taller person and shorter person measuring, by using their hand palm or cubit or stride. Imagine long person has long length of the what is palm or foot palm or cubit. Okay, then they can walk with more stride also. Is it or not? But short person having less length of those body parts. By that what happens? So there is some different type of allegations will possible to get the exact value. That's why we were utilized such a dog, it is not exactly giving, that's why we stop to utilize those methods of conventional methods to measure the length or distances. Okay, how do you understand? So by person to person it was changing, person to person it is changes. So that's why we were stopped. Then finally we already discussed meter, we discovered a system unit now we are using to measure length by using fixed values, that we said meter. Meter is a standard unit to measure the length, already we discussed such a like. Is it or not? Of course. Meter is a unit to measure the length. It is a standard unit to measure the length. Meter scale is a standard instrument to measure the length. What I'm saying to you, meter scale is a standard what we can say, standard instrument. Meter scale is a standard instrument to measure the length. Standard instrument means what we can say, a fixed. All over the world should utilize the meter scale to measure the length. It having a fixed length. It having a fixed length. And see what I'm saying to you. Meter scale we are using to measure the fixed means length by using fixed values. And large distance can be measured in kilometers. Large distance is measured by kilometers. Kilometers. Short distance we are using to measure meters. Large distance we are measuring for by using kilometers and miles. Kilometers and miles. Okay. This is general information what we learn in the. Then coming to talk about what is our lesson measuring length. What is our lesson measuring length? Then what is the measure? What is the measure? To talk about the measure, what we can say? See here. Measure the comparison of an what we can say unknown quantity with some known quantity said. Some known quantity is said to be measurement. What we said, measure or measurement. What we said, the comparison of an unknown quantity with some known quantity. If there is a group of unknown things, from that, well, we are taking by what are we know. Suppose, different type of things it will be. Suppose a group of fruits, a mixed fruits, apples, bananas, plum fruits, dark fruits, whatever. Are we able to recognize to separate the fruits individually? Yes, of course. Is it or not? Of course. So we have to compare them. Means we are comparing which are known things, which are unknown things. By that, what we can say to separate such a like those what we are saying measurement or measure. We can measure which is known, which are unknown. So the comparison of an unknown quantity with some known quantity is said to be measurement. And also what we can say. Standard unit. What we learn in our unit? Standard unit. We already learned SI system, international system, or standard system. Okay? Standard international system, such like standard unit. Internationally accepted unit is called standard unit. What we can say? Standard unit means what? International. All world should obey the rules to follow to measure the unit. Okay, the unit which is used by all over the world people. There is no any difference in that. It is a fixed value comes with. Such those we can say fixed or standard unit. What we can say? Fixed or standard unit. Are you understand? Fixed or standard unit, yes. Coming to talk about some more, up to now we utilized kilometer. What we said? Meter. Is a unit to measure the length. Meter is a unit to measure the length. Means meter is a standard unit to measure the length. What we can say? Meter is a standard unit. What we can say? Standard unit to measure the length. Understand? So coming to that, it is for what we can say. Shorter distance, or of course we can utilize sometimes long distances. And also for long distances, long distance is measured by kilometers also. Then what about short distances? Small distances, that what we can say, small distances can measured by centimeters and also millimeters to measure the length. Note on that. You are finished. Then coming to that. Then, while you are measuring length, then what type of precautions we have to use to measure the length? What are the takes to measure the accurate length? Accurate means exact length. What are the precautions? How to measure by using meter scale? Well, we are using meter scale to measure the length. We have to follow some type of precautions. What are the precautions to follow to measure the length by using meter scale? Then coming to that precaution, what you can say, precaution What are those precautions? Suppose this is the length A and B. We have to measure the distance between A and B by using or with help of meter scale or ruler or scale. First thing is, we have to take care what? We have to place scale or ruler along the length. First thing is, we have to place scale or ruler along the length. Second thing, where from we have to measure the length? That ruler zero or ruler scale zero should coincidence to the origin point. Coincidence to the origin point. And third thing, we have to measure the length by looking vertically. By looking vertically from the surface of scale. We should not, one more thing, we should not measure the length by different angles from front side or back side of the value by looking a particular angle, not at exactly 90 degrees. Why? Because it never gives accurate while looking without 90 degrees. Are you understand? Such a type of precautions we should follow to measure the accurate length. Let's see like, what are the precautions to should follow to measure the length. Coming to that, the scale should be placed exactly. The scale should placed exactly. The scale should placed exactly along the length. Along the length to be measured, okay. Then next thing is zero point on the scale should what you have to do should coincide with the coincide with the starting point of the length. Starting point of the length to be measured. What we are saying here, we should place the scale to measure the length along the length. And coming to that next thing is the zero point on the scale should. So where the zero on the scale, that the scale zero should point then where from you are measuring that length. Means the zero of the scale should coincide to the starting point of the length. And coming to that, what we can say, our eye must be vertical. Our eye must be vertical. Means our eye must be vertical above the point or vertically above the point of coincidence. Of a scale where the measurement is to be taken. Okay, and coming to that, the ends of the scale should be measured at least more the time. Means see here, our eye must be vertically above the point of coincidence of scale where the measurements to be taken. Means, suppose if you want to measure the distance between A and B. If you want to measure the distance between A and B, the scale should place along the length to measure the distance between A and B. So what we are using, that ruler or scale should place along the length to measure the length between A and B. And also next thing what we are doing, the zero of the scale the zero of the scale should coincide where from you are starting to measure the length. At the same time, what we are doing here, see here, our eye must be vertically above the point means where we are measuring the distance. Our eye must be vertically where we are measuring the distance. See that? Because if you did not look vertically, we never get accurate value. Means we never get exact value. That's why what I am saying, the ends of the scale should be perfect. How like that? Perfect. Why? Because it should be perfect. They should not be worn out. They should not be worn out. Means you should not find out any break, because if there is any worn out, that means we never get accurate value. And coming to that, the length of the object should be measured at least more than twice. Why we want to measure at least more than twice? Because if you get number of times is the same value, that we can consider as accurate value, means true value. If we did not get same value, if we get different value, what we measure, that makes different to us. It makes false to us. Means it never gives accurate value. It never gives accurate value. Means not giving exact value. Not gives exact value. That's why the average reading should be incorrect. The average should be reading what? Correct reading should take. So that's why we have to measure by using multiple times. The average of these readings gives the, what you can say, readings gives the correct length of the object. Correct length of the object. Okay? By using these precautions, we should measure the length while you are using a scale or ruler to measure the length. If it does not follow such a type of precaution, we never get accurate value. By following such a type of precaution, we may get accurate value, means true value, the exact value of length of an object. So note on that. Finish that. So by following these measurements, mean precautions, we can get accurate value and accurate value to get the to measure the length of an object. While we are measuring the length of an object, to get exact values, we have to follow such a type of measurements or precautions. Then, how to measure the length of a carved path? How to measure the length of a carved path? Let me talk about that. Coming to that, how to measure the length of carved path? To measure the length of carved path, to measure the length of carved path, let's observe to measure the length of carved path. This is the carved path. What is that? Carved path. Or otherwise, imagine this is a carved path. Or otherwise, if you have what? If it is a thread, imagine what I'm saying. If it is a rope, what I'm saying to you, rope. If it is a rope, the rope in the shape of in particular. Then how to measure length of those? To measure the length of that. We have to follow some instructions to measure length of the curved path. If it is straight path, if that is a straight path, it is possible to measure by using direct the device to measure the length. But when it is in curved such a type, we have to take a particular instructions. Suppose see here, we have to divide individual parts at a part of the curved path, at the edges of the curved, at a edges of the curve. See here, what we are going to make individual points to the edges of the curve. Edges of the curve. We are making like, so what I am saying, if it is a rope, we are making what disconnect to the curved path. Disconnect to the curved path. Means we are making divide that number of divisions, number of parts from curved path. After that, we are giving name to that A, B, C, D, E, and now by dividing that, it appears as in the straight path A, B, B, C, C, D. What we can say C, D after D. What we can say D. Is it such like the paths are appears in the individual? Small parts or small segments. So by those in the path, divided parts from the curved path or rope, curved rope, those individual parts, individual divided parts will appear in the straight path. By using that, now we can measure the length by using a device to measure the length of the individual subdivided parts. So by that measuring, suppose imagine this is a 10 centimeter. If it is 8 centimeter, if it is 5 centimeter, if it is 2 centimeter, the total is how much it will be? 10, 20, 25 centimeter rope of the length of a rope. How much centimeter? 25 centimeter. So by this way, we can try to measure the length of a curved path. We can measure a length of a curved path. Understand? So by using this type of process, we can try to measure the length of a curved path. path. And coming to that, now, before we learn that what is metric system, is it or not? We learn that metric system. What we learn in that metric system? What we learn, see here, kilo, hectare, deca, is it or not? Of course, we learn such of those, see here one. What I'm saying to you, kilo, hectare, okay, such a like, and deca, metric system, units to measure. And one more, what we learn about that, unit, what we learn, unit, and one more, deci, centi, milli. Is it visible to you that? Yeah, of course. Centi, milli. Some more far we can write those. Deci, centi, milli. Is that visible, clear? Yes. Now coming to talk about, for writing metric system for three different type of fundamental units, length, weight, and capacity means value. So what we can write, see here, so kilometer, kilogram, kiloliter, kilometer, kilogram, kiloliter, and what we can see here, what we can make same as hectometer, and hectogram, and what we can say hectoliter. Same as to that, decameter, decagram, what we can say decaliter. And in that unit, what are parts? Meter, of course, same as gram, liter. This is unit value. These are multiples for those units. These are multiples. Multiples, and what we can say sub multiples. Okay, this for what we can say. Decimeter, decigram, deciliter, and the same thing, what we can say, centimeter, centigram, centiliter, and milli, what we can say, centimeter, centigram, centiliter. These are the metric system units to write. Metric system units to write three type of standards for these fundamental units for what length, weight, and volume or capacity. So each and what we can say by writing such those where it is moving. So it is 10 times each and every. What? How much? 10 times. How much times? 10 times. Each and every is a 10 times greater. What we can say? 10 times. Means what we can say? Kilometer is equal to 10 hectometers. 1 hectometer is equal to 10 decameters. Okay? 1 decameter is equal to 10 meters. 1 meter is equal to, what we can say? 1 meter is equal to 10 decimeters. And 1 decimeter is equal to, so 10 centimeters. 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. Understand? same has to come back. Same has to come back. What we can say? See here. Come back. It is divided by 10. How much? Divided by 10. By 10. Okay. Each and every part we can write like this. By using this metric system for every unit. So write length, to measure the length, to measure the weight, to measure the capacity or value. Note on that. Now finish it all. See here, while you're comparing everything, to write 1 kilometer is equal how many hectograms. Similarly, it is the same as to the 10 times greater. Okay, we can compare every unit for different fundamental quantity by using metric system. Understand? So that's why we written before. Kilo, hectare, deca, unit, deci, centi, milli. Because of each and every it is equal to the 10 times while it comes from left to right. And right to left when we coming from those from submultiples to multiples, it is 10 meters. It is a part of the 10 times is the vector. Is what we can say when we are moving from multiples to submultiples, it is greater than 10 times. 10 times greater than others. Understand? So, more on that. And next, we'll measure, means we'll talk about solutions on how to measure length. Solutions on how to measure length. So, keep learning, make practice well, to practice whatever online test. This is the syllabus for online test. Okay? See you in the next class. Have a good day to you.